Now we look at the physiology of the vestibular system. Okay, in this video what I'll be doing is I'll be telling you the type of receptors which are present, the organs which are responsible for the equilibrium in the vestibule and how they work. Mostly I'll concentrate on the semicircular canals in this video. Then the next video it will be about Ewald's law. Next I'll be talking about the otolithic organs, those are the utricle, the saccule, and finally we'll have neuron collections, like where the signal comes from, where it goes, what it's aimed to do. Okay, so first we need to know about the receptors. We have two main receptors. We have the cristae, so we have the cristae and we have the maculae. Now where are the cristae present? So we have the semicircular canals, so, and they have the ampulla. The cristae are present in the ampulla, okay, and each of them, since the semicircular canals are arranged at perpendicular to each other, so each plane will be having its own dedicated cristae in the respective ampulla. And maculae are nothing but stretch receptors which are present in the utricle and saccule. Okay, now saccule, some of them believe that it's also stimulated by sound. So if there is a dizziness or loss of balance due to high sound, some of them attribute it to saccule. So you can remember that the S in saccule also stands for sound stimulation. Okay, now the cristae are cristae and maculae all have hair cells. If I were to draw a diagram, I'll just draw a diagram so that I'll simplify this. So this is the cochlea. Okay, forget about the cochlea. That's the central part. Then we have ampulla 1, ampulla 2. So we have one semicircular canal, we have another semicircular canal, and we have a third semicircular canal. Okay, and then the utricle and saccule will be here. So these things will be the utricle and saccule. This would be the ampullae of the three semicircular canals. This would be the cochlea. So how do they look histologically? The cristae are like this. There's a cupula, then the nerves which are supplying the hair cells, and the hair cells are in the cupula. So by the way the fluid in the semicircular canal moves, there will be stimulation of the hair cells. So again you have to know a few terms, that's ampullo. So ampullo fugal and ampullopetal. So just like centrifugal and centripetal, ampullo, since we're in the ampulla, if the flow of the fluid is towards the ampulla, it's ampullopetal, and if it's away from the ampulla, it's ampullofugal. The stimulation is only done by ampullopetal. So if it's the ampulla, and if this is the semicircular canals, and if the fluid is coming in this way, this is ampullopetal, this leads to stimulation, and if the fluid is going in this manner, it's ampullofugal and it will lead to inhibition. Now how does the otolithic organs, that's the maculae, look? There will be a membrane, again there are hair cells, nerves from the hair cells, they are embedded in something called a otolithic membrane. Since they are stretch receptors, they need to be stretched. So by relative displacement of this and this, okay, by the relative displacement of the otolithic membrane and the basement on which the hair cells are lying, they will be stretched, and that's how they will be stimulated. Now we'll get into the semicircular canals. Semicircular canals are stimulated by angular movement, okay, not by linear movement. Your head has to rotate or your body has to rotate, only then will the semicircular canals be stimulated, unlike the maculae which are stimulated by linear acceleration. You need to have angular acceleration, like rotational motion. Now when rotational motion occurs, there's something called a push-pull system. Okay, push-pull system states that you have a head and you have two vestibular organs. So imagine you're rotating your head in the horizontal plane, then the horizontal canal of this side and the horizontal of canal this side, the fluid movement will take place in both. But the thing is, ampulla and ampulla, if your head movement is towards this side, okay, then the fluid will go in the opposite direction. Why? Because of inertia. You can't make the fluid move, you can only move your head, but due to result of that and the inertia, the fluid will move in the opposite direction. So the fluid in this one will show fugal motion and the fluid in the other one will show petal motion. So you're actually stimulating one and inhibiting the other. So if your head rotates to the right, there will be stimulation of the horizontal canal in the left side while there is inhibition of the canal in the right side. This is the push-pull mechanism. So one has to be activated, the other will be inhibited. But then again, your brain calculates all of this and it leads to your understanding of balance. Okay, so again, in the Evard's law, I'll tell you which canal leads to what and in which plane they are, and in the next video after that we'll talk about the otolithic organs and how they work. Anyway, thank you for watching. I'll see you in my next video.